Okay, good today. And pop.
Good morning, family. What can I say? God woke us up on this beautiful day. He's generous, he's wonderful, he's kind and great. So let's show the Father we appreciate. God's good, God's good, God's good. Good morning, family. What can I say? God woke us up on this beautiful day. He's generous, he's wonderful, he's kind and great. So let's show the Father we appreciate. God's good, God's good, God's good. God's good, God's good, God's good.
Yeah, Mike Guy Morning Show. Tell your mama now. Well, y'all sure gonna get used to that flyer. I put it up there enough. Good morning. Hey, everybody. It's your boy, Michael Kai. It's the Michael Kai Morning Show. It's another beautiful day. What is this day? I think we're all the way up to the 10th by now. It's only April 9th. April 9th show 794. We got so much stuff going on over here that I haven't even realized that we're only 6 days from our 800th. Show. I mean, we celebrate so much stuff. I've already almost missed that. So this is also 157 days married to the most incredible woman in the whole wide world. Hi, baby. Hi. Good morning. Good morning. Sonia, the lovely one. And it's also 38 days before the fabulous. Da 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 da. Before the fabulous special, the King of Venice Beach is built and done. You know, I'm looking to people build the stage right now. It is off the chain. I'm learning so much about people who are my friends and people who pretend to be my friends and people who get mad if I remind them that they're my friends. I'm learning so much stuff on here. We have yet another producer, brand new producer on the show, Miss Rhonda Mormon. Is a fantastic actress, Malika Blessing's best friend, and they're in the show together, Wicked City. Last night, she dropped that bill, booty, boo, boo. You know, it only takes $1,000 to be a producer. Understand, when this thing falls, and I'm talking about, in case y'all ain't following me, the special we're shooting May 17th on Venice Beach, called The King of Venice Beach. And this thing is going to be spectacular. It's going to be outstanding. It's going to be so great. And the folks who are producers, when them credits roll, your name rolls in the credits as well. So 3-4 years from now, everybody talking about how great the show was, and you go get that job, you know, say, you know, I produced that. I produced my career. Okay, anyway, I think y'all understand how that goes. All right, anyway, things are looking so good. Today, let me see. I try to see if I get something put up and see if I get it up in time. If it is, I want to share something with y'all before I bring on my... Oh, wow. Solo's on already. I think this is it. Okay. I'm going to play this twice. Sorry. But I like it so much. The first time, you're not going to see everything. Let's see. Here we go. I want you to just pay particular attention to the different individuals and what they do. And my favorite is the guy who all he does is go, he scratches himself, does this, and then coughs. Then he changes hands. He scratches himself, does this and then cough, and this is part of the music. One guy just got his stick. He just tapping. The guy on the wall, anyway, it's exciting stuff to me. I'm going back and do it one more time. I'm sorry. Bear with me. Here we go. Elevator music. Got to the floor. Ding. Hey, let's get started, y'all. I'm your boy Michael Kaye. This is the Mike Kaye Morning Show. And as you know, today is Tuesday. Good morning, everybody. Welcome. Glad you're up. Get up, shake it up, break it up, and let's get ready for rock and roll. I have the co-host right here, the lovely, the fabulous Straya Black, because Straya is funny. How you doing, baby?
Good morning, Kaye Clan. Today's my brother's birthday. Happy birthday.
Oh, yay. You know, I'm mad with him, though. He needs to call me because he couldn't make your show. And we did five shows. That was too important for him not to make it. Then he gonna show up the day after, trying to hang out. Well, happy birthday. How old is he? 14?
No, right.
Like his age. How old is he for real?
I think 32, 3. I don't know. I know that's bad.
What?
Y'all he's 30-something.
Y'all got the same mom and daddy, right?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, okay.
I know I should know how old he is. I don't, sorry.
Hey, so how you doing? You good? You ready for rock and roll?
I'm ready to rock this joint. I even got on my rock and roll shirt.
Oh, let me see.
Rolling Stones.
Oh, yay. And looks like Miss Katie may have found her way to the studio.
Yay!
I don't know about all the yay shit. Okay, when they be missing in action, I ain't down with all that, but let's see what she is. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, here she is, Katie, on the AF. Welcome to the show, Ms. Katie. How are you today?
I am doing the best that I can.
Oh, well, I'm glad. I hope that's good. I don't know.
Well, I'm here, so that's kind of good. Everybody, hi, how are you, Clint? First of all, on live TV, live air, the best morning show on earth, I want to apologize to my boss and let my boss know what's going on. I wanted to tell him so he can react in front of y'all. Boss, your producer body crashed yesterday. I woke up at 1:50 during the eclipse, and I didn't know what was going on. And I think the retrograde is here that we've been waiting on. Remember, you tried to do it in January. My computer won't allow, I'm on my phone. My computer will not allow me to find any internet.
Straya, could you get the violin? Straya, grab the violin. All right, go ahead.
She was eclipsing too.
I don't gotta make excuses because I make money now.
Yeah, but you don't make appearances, and that's the problem. So anyway, it's a wonderful day. It's Tuesday. We got a great show ahead of us. We are glad she's back, though, even though, you know, she come when she want to. But there she is.
One more question. Can you see Ready now? Because I called him while he was trying to go on when I heard what was going on.
Yeah, I see Ready now.
I walked him through it, so I still be producing even when I ain't appearing. You welcome.
Yeah, you're welcome, too. So anyway, beautiful day today. Hey, y'all, let's get rolling. We got to get going. All right. In fact, let me go ahead and push that button too, because you probably ain't here for the. Hey, y'all, we getting right to the comedy. We got so much stuff to do. Very excited about everything. 38 days until the show. If you haven't had a chance to go to Indiegogo, don't be afraid. Go and put something on there, because you're gonna be in good company at a great show. All right. So with that out of the way, I think this would be a good time to just show you one more little piece of tape, and then we're gonna get started. Okay. I like this. We'll be right back. I'm sorry. That is so fly. Let's get started. We have a comedian waiting on deck to go rock and roll. He is ready because he's already. Let me go and hit the thing. No, because I got to do thing. Got to do thing right, baby. And I just go.
That's right, folks. It's time for Michael Collier's Comedy Corner. Come on, somebody. Some of the funniest comedians on the planet have been on this show. Over 400 comics have done their dance right here at the Comedy Corner. It's going to be funny. I'll tell you right now, if you ain't funny, woo, it's going to be a long walk back to your car. We're going to talk about you. Ooh, we're going to say some terrible stuff. You're going to hate us. So you better be good because it's the Michael Collier Comedy Corner.
Yeah, my brother had a little trouble getting in here, but he in here now. Let me bring the rest of the folks so we be ready before we bring him on. Ladies and gentlemen, get your hands together for Ready. Ready! Good morning. How you doing, King?
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I thought I heard some of that Wakanda music in the morning just now. The first joint, I thought you was going to do a clapback battle with Charleston White. You kept calling him everything but his name.
Oh my God. I called him Carlton. I'm sorry.
Caramel White.
But Caramel White. To another, he was supposed to understand a comedian to a comedian. A heathen to a comedian.
Yo, you got to be grateful, ladies and gentlemen. Be grateful that we didn't know Mr. Michael Collier back then. I seen where that hand went up. He said he don't know me like that. I got an uncle. When that hand go like this, don't make me go back to the bag. You know, don't make me go back to my bag. All right.
Ready? Oh, man.
Oh, yeah. Appreciate it. People try to make me feel bad about eating healthier. Like, how you going to play out water? You still drink water? You crazy. You be drinking water? Yes, I drink water. How the hell think I survive? Lord have mercy. I appreciate the love that you keep sending me. I appreciate the love you keep spreading. That's what I'm doing. That's what we're doing here. That we do. I can't see right now, but I thank you. Thank God for the eclipse. It has super, super, super healing. I stood out in the sun and I realized I really didn't have to pay that Netflix bill. And I'm starting to realize a lot of these bills you really don't have to pay. As long as you got family members. I started off my own Netflix, but I got the $6.99 one, the one with the commercials. Nobody's asking for my passcode. Like, man, get that out of here. You got the commercials. You could have stayed with the free TV. I tried. And I'm glad you kept your cool, Straya. I seen your face. Let me down, boss. Let me down. Let me go, boss. Let me go. He don't know me, dude. He don't really know me. Okay. I just gave my life to the Lord a few weeks ago. Okay? I was shocked. I was like, oh, Lord. Oh, my goodness. Can't believe it's going down like that. But I appreciate the love that you keep spreading. I appreciate the information and the people that you're bringing through here. All types, from the well-educated to the ones that don't care if they made it up in here. You understand me? So keep up with the love, man. Keep up with the love. You need to have me on here talk to you a little bit longer. I want to say something to y'all. And what's your name again, young lady? I appreciate your help. I'm going to need you later on in life because I might not be able to know how to use the phone. You know, me and my mama stuck on this Amazon thing. We can't even order yet because we don't know how to get into the phone like that.
What is your take on Carlton White?
Well, technically, I feel his pain because you kept calling me already. But another thing,
that's how you have it written as R already. I stopped dropping a second R off the front.
No, It's abbreviations, it's dot, dot, dots in between. It's righteously re-educate distracted youth in the mind.
Righteously re-educate
that's distracted like youth in the mind.
Already. Okay. And what I've seen, right. I'm distracted.
What I've seen on that, okay, like the lady had said, did all that, you got your fame and everything, but what you want to be known for? What's your legacy?
Mm-hmm.
Some people just, they're in pain. By the same token, I'm not going to exploit my pain and others for gain. Mm-hmm. That's what has been going on, because I've seen a lot, I've watched a lot of stuff, and I watched that man a lot, you know, but then I seen like, he's doing it on purpose, but not with a purpose.
Mm.
You know what I mean? He might have started off with a purpose, because I seen when he had the bow tie on, and then I seen when he split and tried to do the thug stuff.
Right.
But when you go to a point where you go way beyond disrespect, because even in the underworld, it's a line you're not supposed to cross. But when you crossing that line, it's something deep within you. You broken. You need to heal first before you go out and try to heal. That's all. Got a little deep, little man.
That was perfect. Actually, it was better than your set this morning. You can come on here anytime you want to. I just, your take on everything is always so funny and so cool, brother.
Appreciate you
and what's going on.
Question: do y'all sell pork over there at that restaurant?
Yes, we do.
I seen the thing, but I ain't seen no porks on it. So I was like, yeah, we in the building.
She have some of the best pork chops. Smothered, fried.
Yeah, you know, we ain't supposed to touch that swine. It's in the book. So
that's my uncle. That's my uncle, y'all.
We're not supposed to fornicate either, but
okay.
That's not on the dang on menu.
Help me find you, sir.
They'll find me as soon as I start shining, baby. Shining
already, brother. I see you. You shining bright like a diamond. Leave us with a woo woo woo, sir.
I say the woo 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 woo.
Give it up, please. Ready. And that second R is silent. Okay, that dude's hilarious without even trying. Dr. Sabrina got a good sense of humor, too. She also has a new show. And we got to bring on, see what she's talking about. She's fantastic, y'all. It's Taco Tuesday, everybody. I'm getting that's what I'm going to have this morning, a breakfast taco. I'm going to scramble some eggs, fry some bacon, really crunchy so I can break it up and put it in there. I'll put a little salsa on there and have it in a taco shell. Bam! Right there. You must be muted or something, Katie.
You can't hear me.
Oh, I heard you say you can't hear nothing else.
Can you hear me now?
Okay. Nah, I can't hear you now. Hey, all right. Okay, wait a minute. So let's get to the wonderful Dr. Sabrina Jackson. Let me slide you to the big window, mama.
Hey, yeah. How y'all doing? Hi, Rich Auntie. Hey. Hey, girl. Hey.
Hello, kid.
Okay, so let me tell you what I want to talk about today, because I'm super excited about it, because I was talking to a group of women this past weekend, okay. And I asked the question, what does success look like? Mm. When you are successful, mm. when things are going good, what mm. things can you see happening in your life? And so a lot of times we look for all the major positive things, but there's some things that start happening that we may not like, we may not feel it, but it is mm. true. So I'm going to give you a little bit of both. I'm going to give you 7 things to look for when you are doing well. The first thing is that when you make decisions, you're making greater, better decisions than you did maybe 6 months ago. So stop in the moment and look at the decisions that you made 6 months ago versus the decisions that you're making now. When you are doing well, you make better decisions. This second one is serious. The second one is
you are attracting more haters.
How are they attracting more haters?
You attract more haters because when things are going well for you, people that don't like you.
Oh, yeah. They come out the woodwork.
Okay. They come out the woodwork. And so let me say this. It is scriptural because the word says that God prepares a table for me in the presence of my enemy. Presence means proximity. That means you have to be at my table to see my table. So the haters are always close. And so for me, when I start to see haters, I begin to get excited because what that means is that my table is being spread. God is doing some good things for your girl. And so stop looking at the haters, giving them power to get you off your square. Stay focused on your table because things are going well for you. Number three, more people will begin to ask you for your assistance, for your opinion, or your mentorship. When things are going well for you, people see you and then they want to learn from you. So when things are going well, people are going to start asking you, what do you think? Can I sit with you? Can I talk with you? Can I run something by you? That's another sign that things are going well for you. Number four, clarity. You have clarity about what you want and you have a plan to achieve it. So when things are going well, you have clarity about this is where I need to move and this is the plan to move there. Sometimes when we're kind of off our square, we don't have a plan. We're just kind of fumbling around. But when things are going good for you and you know that God is giving you something to do, when he gives you a vision, it's never on a conference call. He's never giving you a vision with a whole bunch of people around. He's talking directly to you. And when you have the vision, then you know that you have to do what's necessary to make the steps so that he can blow his super on your natural. And when he's blowing his super on your natural, that makes supernatural blessings. Number five.
Hey, I just want to tell you, that's one of my favorite things you say. When he blows some super on your natural. Woo! All right. Fine. Go ahead. Okay.
Number five, your inner circle gets smaller. When things are going well for you, the haters around you can't take it. And sometimes the haters around you that can't take it are people that you love or that you care about, but they can't handle the anointing that is on your life. They begin to compare their life with your life. There is a story in the scriptures about Saul. When Saul let David come and kill the giant, people around him start talking about David. They were uplifting David, and Saul didn't like it. And so Saul became jealous about what other people were saying about David. Sometimes people around you will help you, will do things to uplift you. But then when people give you more shine than they got shine, sometimes they can't handle it. And so this is the thing I know, is that when God is blessing my neighbor, that means he's in my neighborhood. And that means blessings can come my way too. I can't compare my blessings to your blessings because what God has for me is uniquely crafted just for me. Just as what God has for you is uniquely crafted just for you. Number six, you challenge yourself to improve in specific areas of your life, that you take a moment and you look at your life and you go, I can improve here. I may make to work on my time management. I need to maybe work on how I talk to people. Maybe I need to talk to myself more positive than I do negative. Get rid of that stinking thinking. Start to say positive things to yourself about yourself. So when you make that analysis, you are not beating up on yourself that you need to make these improvements. You are owning that there are places and spaces for improvement. And don't you know, as long as you're living, there are going to be some places and spaces for improvement. And number seven, you worry less and trust everything is happening for a reason. I say every single thing, that everything is working out for me. Everything is working out for me. When it looks like it's not working out for me, guess what? is working out for me, because I understand what the word says, that all things are working together for my good. And he did not say just the good things. He said all things. So he uses everything. So just like yesterday, we had an eclipse. And in the eclipse, we saw that God showed us that dark and light can occupy the same space at the same time. So sometimes the dark spaces that you've been through, God will shine a light on it, and then he'll use it for your good. He'll use it to bless other people. Your pain has purpose. Ooh. And do you know that he'll allow your pain to pay you? And so that is my word for today.
It is fantastic. You got a lot of words in there. I got to get in here. I got to ask you about a little bit of this first.
Okay.
What I really love is the analogy that you put out, just simply saying, I know he's here. You know, knowing that God is here. So when you say this statement, when God is blessing my neighbor, I know he in my neighborhood. I didn't want people to go past that quickly, because the truth is, a lot of us forget that God is always presence. The goodness of God is everywhere. There is no place where the Holy Spirit does not reside. Yes. I don't care how bad, terrible, angry, ugly, stanky a place is, or how great and beautiful. God resides everywhere where he is. Every place that exists, there is God. And then knowing that, you can call on him at any time, because he's right there. You know, right, you ain't got a long distance. You ain't got to get on the internet. You can call him right there, because he is an indwelling spirit that you can call on all the time. That's why that statement is so cool, because sometimes we forget he's in our neighborhood. We forget he's here for us. You know, so that one. And then one thing, we've been ringing this theme for a couple of days. Sometimes some of the worst people in your life is a damn family member.
Let me tell you what I say about that.
Yes.
Just because we're related does not mean I have to be in relationship with you.
Mm-hmm.
I choose who's in my circle. I choose who I share my dreams with. I choose who I share my challenges with. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I choose, because I have to trust that where I send it, it's going to be safe. So I know, I'm just going to use you and I for an example. When I call you and I say that something is going on with me, whether it's good or bad, I trust that you have my best interest in heart. Yeah. You know, the last time I was supposed to be here, I wasn't feeling well. And so I text you, I said I wasn't feeling well. The first thing you says is, I'm praying for you and I'm going to light a candle for you. That's who I want to be in relationship with. I don't want to be in relationship with somebody when I say I'm not feeling good. Well, what you doing? You must not be doing something right. Because, you know, people will start hating on you. Well, wow. You're doing too much. You're too busy. You need to slow down. Well, I'm busy because God put a lot of things on my plate.
Mm-hmm. I'm busy.
And so I need people in my circle that's going to lift me, that's going to support me, that's going to encourage.
Uh-oh, I see she got a phone call. You busy. You okay. Just said you busy a minute ago.
You can't hear me now.
I can hear you. I can hear you. Yes, we can hear you.
I so hate it.
We could hear her.
So hate it.
I love it. Okay, let me bring you
hate it.
It's okay. Can you hear us now, Dr. Sabrina?
I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Can I just tell you, that was life, what you just said. All 10 things is like testimonial things that I'm going through right now. So that is crazy what she said. I mean, one by one. That's mind-blowing. Better decisions, attracting more haters, more people will ask for your opinion, clarity, your inner circle will get smaller. I mean, everything that she's saying, challenge yourself and sir, everything she's saying is what I'm going through. So I want to just say thank you. It was very powerful what you're saying, like, period, hands down. I'm grateful for it.
Let me tell you, I am actually doing a devotional right now. It's a 10-day devotional, and it's on YouVerse, the Bible app, and it's called Unoffendable. Because if you can become unoffendable, then stuff outside of you can't negatively impact you. And so one of the things that I struggle with, and I'm just going to be transparent, is phantom discouragement. And phantom discouragement is when somebody that you value starts to talk positively and blow somebody else up, and they've never blown you up, then you get discouraged because they didn't do it for you, but you see them doing it for others. So what I have to learn is, if they didn't do it for me, it still doesn't change anything about me. It still doesn't change the fact that I'm powerful and what God has given me. So why would I give that person, even if I care for them, more power than I give God and what God is doing for me in that moment? Mm-hmm. So I have to work on not looking at how somebody else is treating me, but always stay focused in what God is doing, not only to me, but through me.
Mm. Well, that's good stuff. That's good stuff. Doc Sabrina, somebody say it's powerful in the spirit of God. Spirit of God. And that's Paulette, Elder Paulette. You, man, all the stuff you said really landed today.
Yep.
You have the new show. When is the new show coming?
The new show is coming out. It'll be on Roku and Apple TV the mid-May. So one of the things that the show is going to be on a new network, and so the new network is getting all their pieces and stuff together. In fact, I was involved in helping pick the logo and for the new network. But as soon as everything launches, you know y'all gonna be the first to know. Because, you know, my brother is my very first guest on the show. And let me say this. I'm super excited because I'm going to Kenya on the 24th of this month. And my team, the production team, is coming with me. And we're going to film all while we're in Kenya.
Oh, my God. How long are you going to be there?
I'll be there from the 24th to May the 1st. And I'm specifically going, this is another announcement, but the Detroit Youth Choir, which was on America's Got Talent, and they are a very talented group of young people, they are going to perform at the International Festival of Choirs. Wow. And so I have been deemed their mental wellness coach, and so I'm traveling with them.
And this is Kenya?
Yes, Kenya, Nairobi, Kenya.
So the whole choir is going to Kenya?
Yes.
That's awesome. That's so awesome. I'm trying to get to Africa this year, too, after May 17th. All my focus is on May 17th, the King of Venice Beach. But I've already talked to Miguel Nunez. He keeps going back and forth to Nigeria. I'm getting to Africa this year. Focus.
I am going in October because another blessing that came my way, there's a group called the Curvy Girl Project, and it's for full-figure teens. I speak for them often, and now they have a chapter in Ghana. So we're going to Ghana in October for the Curvy Girl Project.
That's nice.
Well, me and Charlie's Angels, we need to come to Africa, baby. These two girls need that culture.
Yes, we all do. And I just think that we need to all expand our mind and our vision. Mm-hmm. Stop staying stuck in what you see around you. There's a big old world. Let's go on and get in it.
Yeah,
and I will be there.
She had another call.
There it go. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
You can hear me? Okay, good. I am coming on May 17th. I'll be there. I have my ticket. I'll be there in the morning. I can't wait.
It's going to be great. So, I love you. Leave us with a woo, woo, woo.
Oh, I can't hear you.
Okay.
Oh, woo, woo, woo.
Give it up.
From the rich auntie.
Jackson, woo, 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 woo. Won't he do it? I love her. And always great advice. Yes, dear.
It is so weird because when Straya said that, I don't know if you saw me in the back when she was talking. Straya is telling the truth, y'all. Everything that she said today, me and Straya have been talking about this all weekend and struggling through this all weekend and last night.
Oh, like, she was able to find you last night. Oh, that's
pretty. You and see the haters, see how they come? They said, and that it's going to be people that you know personally. They come out
in a circle.
Wait a minute. Guess who's here now? Damn it, DJ. Damn it, yes. DJ is here with some nonsense to follow all these great words. I love this dude. He is funny. Get your hands together once again for damn it, DJ. Damn it, DJ.
Hello.
Big mirror. Bam.
There we go. Hello, hello. How are you guys doing today? Hello. Before I get started, I just wanted to say, Katie, you are hilarious because I love how you dressed up like Michael today because you weren't producing the show this morning. She got in that closet. She said, I'm going to show him who got the best hat in the city.
I'm mad about that hat. I almost got that hat. She beat me. Mm-hmm. That's the man. That was good.
She knew that she wanted that hat. That's why she wore it, and she had the nerve to tilt it.
Oh, all down, everything like that. How you doing, DJ?
I'm great. Speaking of, we have a lot to go through today. TD James is first up on the docket. Then we are going to visit Eclipse. TD James, he's a pastor.
He do the same thing that you did to Charleston White. You call Charleston White Carlton. He called T.D. Jakes T.D. James. It's all good.
But wait.
T.D. Jakes. I'm sorry. T.D. Jakes.
Oh, my God. I thought you were talking about a new T.D. Okay. T.D. James. Reverend T.D. James. Okay, I'm sorry.
Yes. T.D. James. There's not too many T.D.s on this earth. Let's just keep it 100. But anyways, T.D. Jakes is a 66-year-old pastor, and he's a gorgeous story. I'm going to go ahead and just briefly describe him before we get into the mess, because, ooh, child, this is messy. But anyways, he is a 66-year-old senior pastor of the Potter's House, which he founded in 1996. He led a popular women's ministry, and he had plenty of partnerships helping underprivileged minorities. A very, very fantastic man with such a gorgeous resume of helping others. Why am I bringing it up today? Yeah. Because of Diddy. Now let's talk about it. So, in a recent lawsuit that was coming out, we all know about the Diddy drama, and what Diddy was found out doing was he was taking advantage of TD Jakes and his likeness and his image to make him seem more holy within the whole case drama. And apparently within this process, he invited TD Jakes to several Diddy parties, to which apparently, according to the documents, TD Jakes did come and participate within the parties, but we're going to get there shortly. TD Jakes was allegedly arrested this weekend, or like recently within the past month. However, that was found false. He wasn't arrested, though he should be, based off of some of the stuff that we found out. Like, say, for example.
No, I don't think he should be. What stuff have you found out?
Let me tell you.
All right.
So, he was, like I said, he had his punch card for the Diddy parties and was obviously going often. And one thing about he was using it. He was one punch away from getting a free Diddy. Like
no Diddy. All
right, but one thing about it was that he was often, like, he frequented these parties often and allegedly, these are all allegations, allegedly participated in homosexual relations on several occasions. And yes, it was to the point where the male escorts there at the parties were referring to him as a power bottom. Oh my God. So for those who don't know what a power bottom is, let's just say in gay interactions, there's some people that take and there's some people that give. And let's just say.
Hey, let's go to the next story. What's the next?
Yes. So, speaking of the next story, J. Cole. Now, I brought up a lot of last time I was here, I brought up a lot of drama about how J. Cole and Kendrick Lamar and Drake were all in beef. And last thing we know, Kendrick Lamar shot a diss at J. Cole and Drake, but didn't receive anything back. That was until this last week. J. Cole dropped an album called Might Delete Later, and the final song on the album is called 7-Minute Drill. That song, he went ham
on Kendrick. Shot a lot of diss on it, but later in the week he apologized. Was like, you know what, I'm not really like that, and took the diss back. There's a lot of popular opinions on this. Like, he literally was like, you're stupid. I'm sorry, y'all. My actions this week was really, really bad, and I shouldn't have done all that. lots of different people feel really type of ways about it. Say, for example, 50 Cent thinks that J. Cole was kind of a weakling for pulling back a diss. And some people were like, well, if he wasn't spiritually in line with dissing somebody, he just wanted to take it back and make it right. So what's your guys' opinion on that? Like, do you think that if somebody throws out a diss and it's like, you know what, I take it back, I'm not really like that, I'm sorry. Do you think that it's more so about spiritual journey or more about morals?
I think morals. It's silly to spend any time paying attention to this. I think what's the whole point? I mean, if somebody loves you, they love you. If they don't, they don't. And then when you realize who the people are who don't, you just ignore them and you walk in the other direction of the people who did you. You know, that's all. I mean, my thing, I've always been, if you like me, I love you. If you don't like me, well, F you too. It's pretty much what I don't have a great area in that. So don't worry about the people. People who got negative stuff to say about you probably are people who will never do anything good for you anyway. So their opinion doesn't matter. I know if I was a millionaire somewhere, I wouldn't be giving a damn about what anybody got to say about me. You help yourself say what you want to say.
Quiet. Are you not a millionaire? I thought you was like a trillionaire.
I'm a trillionaire in my heart, in my mind. Right now, I'm a thousandaire with Straya. Me and Straya, thousandaires right now.
I see you. Let me hold a dollar. Speaking of, let me hold in the dollar. A whole bunch of 99-cent stores have been officially shut down. That is over. There's no more 99-cent stores in America. So that's very, very heartbreaking for those people who only got a dollar to spend.
When did this happen? When did the 99-cent stores
begin? Last week, they announced that they're done. No more are being open. All of them are being shut down.
Do you mean like Dollar Tree or...
No, there's an actual store. There's a store brand that was over and closer to the older generation called 99 Cent.
And in New York. So when I lived in New York, it's thousands of them, and it's legit called 99 Cent. It was 99 Cent. It's thousands of them in New York. So I know exactly what he's talking about.
But I haven't seen one in forever. I know it used to be.
Well, why are they closing?
Because everything's too expensive. Ain't nothing 99 cent no more. Back in the day, you were able to buy a house for $5. Now, Family Dollar's maximum product is $7. I'm sorry, $7. $7 is crazy. That used to be like a house and a girl.
Well, on the other side of that, the 99 cent store spurned 100 other stores with the word dollar in it. Dollar Tree, Green Dollar, Family Dollar, Mini Dollar, Super Dollar. They're all over the place. And they're the most successful stores that's out right now. Called people who ain't got no money, they feel like they're getting a lot when they come out with a cart full of stuff that costs a dollar each. You know?
Absolutely.
And it works for them. Those stores are popping up everywhere. So that's really interesting to hear that the 5.99 cent store quit. Why don't they just add a penny and they just stay in the game with everybody else? Okay, we got to go.
You would think that they would pull it together. Like, I love dollar stores. That's where I found my last boyfriend at. Like, real nice and cheap. Just go in there, grab whichever one. When it breaks, buy a new one.
You tell me that nigga wasn't worth a dollar?
Absolutely not. I returned it. They gave me 50 cent back. Anyway.
Okay, well, wrap it up. Gotta go.
Yes. So finally, speaking of, everyone was talking about the eclipse. I just wanted to bring it up really, really, really quickly. One positive thing about the eclipse is that it's just a chance to be able to reset and bathe in your new energy. As you see, a lot of older stuff has been passing on. So, say, for example, the 99 cent store, a lot of rap regents have been stepping down. A lot of people have been getting exposed. So this is a time to really reset and take inventory of who you are and make sure you're blessing yourself. As we said beforehand, if you are spiritually in line, like Dr. what was her name again?
Sabrina Jackson.
Sabrina. Yes, I loved her entire message, even though she did have several eclipses. But like, my favorite thing is that it's really, really, really important to manifest and protect your own energy. Mm-hmm. And with that, my name is Damn It DJ. I'm protecting my energy today by doing some ball head with my friends out in the street. So if you see me in the streets, clap your flan because I clap back.
Clap your fan. Thank you, DJ. Damn it, DJ. Welcome to the show. We'll see you next Tuesday, man, with some more little tidbits of information.
Absolutely.
They leave us with the woo woo woo.
Woo woo woo. Woo woo woo.
Damn it, DJ, right here on the Mike Kite morning show with a little clap. I didn't know what that was. All right. So, it's prayer time. And then, guys, you know this is Tuesday. For me, the highlight of every Tuesday is Tommy J. Tommy J is a brilliant musician, an awesome artist, and just a great guy, you know. And every time he brings music here, it's different. It's something special. What's my aunt saying? Okay, my aunt said to be free is to never be concerned with public opinion. Thank you, Auntie. What folks are saying and thinking about you. When you love yourself and others unconditionally, you automatically attract love. That's very good. Something else Sabrina touched on today, too, is what she says each morning. Everything works out for me. Everybody should really try to have at least a positive affirmation, at least one. Every morning to start your day, I say the same thing she said. Every day I say, everything always works out for me. I said it every day in the mirror, every day. Everything works out for me. And it works out because you're the one training the universe. You're the one teaching the universe what to give you, because the universe is an open plane that wants you to have everything, but you have to set your intention. By setting your intention, the universe knows what you want and starts supplying the things necessary for you to have it. You know, so I just really love her. She's so fabulous. And I love my aunt, Teresa Delswin, 83 years young, and she is also what? A producer on the King.
of this we love Aunt Teresa.
Yes, we do. She is the bomb.com, and she just stole the wedding. She was a star at the wedding. And look, I gotta, before I go to the West End, I gotta hit a commercial, guys. Before we go to prayer, let me just hit you with this commercial, right? Not that one. Let's go with. Okay, I'll do this one.
Looking for a good way to start your day? Check out the Michael Kaya Morning Show. I mean, we have fun over there. Imagine if you started every day with laughter and prayer. Just imagine how powerful you'd be. We have a comedian every show, a vocalist or poet every show. We have awesome conversation, ridiculous situations, and every show we pray. Oh man, just go to YouTube and put in the Michael Kaya Morning Show, 7 a.m., 5 days a week, Monday through Friday, and we'll do the rest. Come hang out with us. Holla.
It's prayer time, baby. Hey, let's get that prayer in. Let's start with a holy breath. Hold that. And think one positive thought. Somebody gonna give us another $10,000 for the King of Venice Beach today. Wow! Amen. Exhale. Father God, we open our hearts, our souls, our minds, our spirits, and invite you to come on in and fill us with your love, your peace, your passion, your joy, your sense of kindness, your sense of understanding, and teach us how to be more forgiving. Teach us how to forgive everybody for everything. We think they've done to us. But most importantly, let us forgive ourselves for everything we think we've done. God, we know that you love us by the way you treat us. It's so wonderful that we was talking today about love and how relationships are, how people, someone be backstabbing, someone be playing like they're your friends and they not. But with you, God, I can really say this statement and mean it. I know you love me by the way you treat me. So, Father God, let me start by saying thank you. I woke up this morning with an attitude of gratitude. Waking up alone, I already won right there. So, thank you, God. Thank you for our lives. Thank you for the show. Thank you for the beautiful co-hostesses that I have who show up and are funny and brilliant. Thank you for the Kaya Clan. Thank you for my wife. Oh, I'm missing Sonya. I got to hurry up and get off this show so I can see my wife face some more today. She is, to me, everything. Not just everything. She's everything. That's everything with a little R slapped on that. And God, you're so great. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for our health. Thank you for another opportunity. Thank you for abundance. Thank you for the elimination of fear. Thank you for our lives continually getting better and better every moment because we give it all to you, Father God. All good things come from you. So let this day be supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Then put some steak on it. Continue to be the wind beneath our wings, Father God, as we fly and soar and navigate this thing called life. Help us navigate it towards more forgiveness, more love, more graciousness, more kindness. God, let Black people talk to each other again. You know, I just remember when in my neighborhood, if you walk past another Black person, especially an adult, and you didn't speak, man, your mama grab you on that little gristle part of your ear. Boy, what's wrong with you? Now, we won't even look at each other. Father God, let us get back to recognizing that we are family. And let us at least be gracious. Let us say hello. Let us speak. That is the beginning of something that can be really, really good. The salutation. Just say hello. Father God, thank you for all of it. And so we say, thank you, thank you, thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, amen, amen. I mean, ashe. Boom, shakalaka. And the famous words of those of us who call ourselves the Kaya Clan. Woo, woo, woo. Thank you, lady. Beautiful job, beautiful job. Yes.
Just one quick thing. You know, I know that you was praying to God saying, talk to us, but I don't need them niggas at the gas station talking to me when I'm going into the gas station. I them the main ones that I ask God, please don't let him say nothing to me. He know I'm nice. So why would he think that I would even talk to him standing outside the gas station? So no, God, keep those people. Some of them people, keep them quiet.
You say you need, know I look nice. So what makes you think I want to talk to the guy outside the gas?
And they be the boldest ones. Katie, you know, going into the gas station, the men and hang outside the gas station. How do you think that you could talk to us?
But Stryer, your thing is, see, you look nice so people talk to you. For something about me, people get ready to say something. They go, how you doing? I go, amazing. It cuts the conversation.
I'm learning.
Hey, let us go to this wonderful cat who I really love Tommy J. I love his spirit and his heart and his energy and what he brings and his creativity. Boy, got a good brain. Big old brain that he is. Big old brain. We're going to him. But first, once again, I have to announce our newest producer on the King's Comedy is the actress Rhonda Mormon. And she put in $1,000 last night while I was on the phone. And I was like, oh my God, this is so great because it's so funny. I just got off the text with a friend. Well, you know, that word is so weird. That whole friend word. But I got off with a friend who was mad because I was asking him to help me with the project. And I said, hey, somebody helped you. Somebody helped you with yours, you know. And he flipped out. What does that mean? And my friends don't come at me like that. I'm coming at you. I'm just reminding you. You know, a lot of people forget theirs and they forget that they're supposed to reach out to other folks. And so if I'm your friend, I should be able to come to you and ask. You ain't got to get mad at me because you don't want to help me. And actually, you mad at you because you ain't going to help me. And then I'm exposing that you ain't going to help me by asking you. Please get off your high horse and go in the corner and get your biscuit or something. Get your life together. All right. Anyway. I said, I'll have to say nothing, I guess.
That sounded nice because I would have said, go play in traffic. What you would have said, Katie?
What my daughter said, go play in the dirt.
Oh, that's...
Katie's mother came to the show Sunday, y'all. I didn't even know she had them. Anyway, Katie, you know, where the hell she come from? And her mother was just sweet as can be.
She was.
That little lady came in and sat front and center.
And laughed.
She has a great sense of humor.
We got it in. Okay, of stone in Jesus' name. Amen. What's that?
My oldest daughter was there too.
Oh, yeah, Maddie. I mean, sorry. Yeah,
yes, she is so cool. Oldest daughter is cool in the game. I'm so glad she was there.
She want to make my world go around.
She said that, I said, you better than Katie. She said, I know I'm the demo.
Okay, without further, let us get to our man, our friend, Tommy J. Uh-oh, I guess somebody's calling somebody.
He the best.
Oh, my God. Derek Keener is calling him on FaceTime and shutting the show down. You doing this in the middle of the show, really? Yes. Yes, Derek.
Hi, Derek. Hi, Derek.
Yes, sir. We're still live, sir. We only go 1 hour and we only got 6 minutes left. So what you want?
I'm at work.
So why you call here?
He said he in jail.
You was calling to talk to me.
He locked up.
No, he ain't in jail. They said, are you in jail? Because those walls do look like jail walls. With them big cement bricks like that, that's how the jail look. Where you at?
Central booking.
I'll call you. The show will be through in 10 minutes. I'll talk to you in a minute. All right.
Derek, it's funny.
How you morning, son?
Hey, Tommy's waiting ever so patiently. Let's get our hands together for Mr. Tommy Shay. Yeah, boy.
Good, everybody. What's up? Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Tommy.
Hey, Tommy.
I have one, two exciting things. Of course, Michael and the rest of the Kaya clan know that I had a wonderful weekend performing 5 shows with Michael Kaya. But I have a cousin who said, she called me and was like, you know Tommy J? I said, yeah, that's my peoples. She said, oh my God, Tommy J, asked him, do he remember we did a video shoot and everything? He the man out here in Baltimore in Washington, D.C. I was like, he said that. He the man all over, so
hey.
Keep doing your thing, Tommy.
I tell people all the time, Baltimore really received me in a way that made me fall in love. They wooed me, and I appreciate and love and see them for everything that they are. I love Baltimore. I would raise my kids in Maryland.
Oh, yeah, they love
wow.
you. My cousin gave you nothing but praises. Was like, oh, my God, you know Tommy J?
She's an artist. She does music.
She does hair. Yeah, I worked on it. She does hair. She's very professional. Super sweet.
We did a shoot together or something.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, Tommy J argue better than anybody I know. We have so much fun arguing.
Y'all be arguing?
No. Katie just keep talking. I'll be done with the shit.
Still keep it coming.
It takes two to argue, Tommy.
All right, what do you have for us musically today, great man?
We got a good little inspirational Tommy J, deep in my bag yet again. This one don't even got a bridge on it yet. It's just two verses and a hook.
All right. Can't go wrong with a hooker. Okay, I'm sorry. All righty then, Tommy J, shall we get out the way and let you go ahead and play?
Yeah, thanks. Good morning, everybody.
One more time, y'all. Give it up for Tommy J.
You got to make sure whatever you're going through that you never let it get you too down, that you can get back up. Lately, it's been real cloudy. I ain't really been able to see my way, so I decided to let the storm pass. But I ended up wasting my whole day. Say it again. Lately it's been real cloudy. Ooh, I gotta win this anymore. I ain't really been able to see my way, so I decided to let the storm pass. But I ended up just wasting my whole day, and it's still raining all the time. Things that we go through in life, it's worth the fight. So face your fears and get up.
down this week. Come back to the Michael Collier Morning Show. The three-day episode, episode 790. You are all good.
Get up.
Right, I'm gonna tell y'all a story. Pay attention to the characters.
No, I'm not a mess. No. The storm passed. I put on my best. Oh. And I'm ready. I ain't Freddy. Who is Freddy? Well, Freddy's dead. Another one lost to the streets. Instead, he could have done something with his life. He had a wife, a house, and kids. But instead, he lives scared. And it's still raining all the time. Yeah. See, the things that we go through in life, they're worth the fight. So face your fears and get up. Get up.
Sometimes you gotta know.
No choice left. You must move forward. No choice left. You must move on. No option left. You must move forward. Oh, no option left. You must move on. I know y'all going through things. I am too. Everything's moving forward. It's already moving, so you might as well get up. Get up, yeah, yeah. Get up, get up. Bring your burdens with you, get up. Get up, bring your heartbreak with you, get up. Yeah, get up, yeah, yeah.
Thank y'all for listening. This is a Tommy J original. It's called Get Up.
Well, that's smooth as hell right there, partner. That it don't get smoother than that, player.
Mm-hmm. I like
that. Come on, y'all. What we doing? What we doing over here? What? Thank you, brother. That was smooth.
Little inspiration for the morning.
That's a good way to get a day started, man. How's your day going? What you doing today special for yourself?
Today, I actually doing some health checks. I'm going in for a physical. I ain't had one in over a year now. So I'm like, let me go check on myself. I am 31. I need to make my checks more regular now.
At least once a year. And I'm proud of you for saying that, because black men need to do more of that.
Yeah, we do.
Make sure, if you can do twice a year, it's better. But it's important. Oh, man, you got so much beautiful stuff that came out years up there. Very nice.
Yeah, because
vibe.
Black men usually only go when they dripping.
Oh, Lord. Now when they dripping. That's crazy. That is so descriptive and visual.
I'm right now all the stuff people saying that he was in there.
Thank you, y'all. The Collier Clan always showing love. I appreciate it. I log on every morning and say what's up to them while the show is getting started, because they are so loyal. And so lovely. Such a lovely audience.
Yeah, I love you, brother. You're excellent. Thank you. Tell people how they can find you. We're getting out of here at a decent hour.
Hey, go follow me at Tommy J Music. We got some really dope things coming up. And Straya and Katie, I'm going to put y'all on my list this week. I'm bumping y'all out of the normal list into the I'm kind of on your head list. And then after this week, if it go another week, then I'm going to be on your ass list. And then yeah, because we got too much talent to be struggling for good talent. Okay. I sent y'all three this week. That would have been wonderful for this morning. Okay. Oh, that's all I'm saying. We'll talk after the show.
Yeah. I got so much stuff up for you, man. Tommy Smooth Groove.
Thank y'all so much. I appreciate it.
Oh man, I love it.
Hey, go back to Tommy. Oh, what was her name? You got to be careful now because people be putting up these profile pictures of like themselves as cartoons. So was she really looking good? Oh, she might. We'll see.
She looks like Brad Pitt's ex, Angelina Jolie. Sorta.
Yes. He calling everybody everything today. Hey, yo, when homeboy said T.D. James, I said, hey, yo. He's got to be talking about somebody else. This has got to be a new story. He said, oh, no, sorry.
He's such a funny guy because I'd be calling him. He said, well, what topic do you want to talk about? I said, okay, well, talk about the fake arrest of T.D. James. This dude came back with a whole biography. And with a whole biography, he still had the name wrong.
Because he's 21. We know who T.D. Jakes is.
Everybody should know who T.D. Jakes is every age. But okay, I know it's a horrific and terrible story. It's more BS that people just put out in public. I was thrown back because when I first heard it, I actually saw a video that looked like T.D. Jakes was handcuffed and being walked out, being purple. And that never even happened. All that stuff that people put up there. What were you saying, Katie?
The internet is undefeated. They will put...
It's undefeated.
I break up with the internet every day because they always just...
Hey, okay, I love y'all. I'm gone. Wait a minute. I got to do it the right way. Let me see. Did I miss anything? One more commercial. Oh, people, please don't forget the main thing. And the main thing... I keep you with me, brother. The main thing is... Give until it hurts. 38 days until we're shooting one of the fantastic, most incredible one-hour outdoor comedy specials ever shot in the history of laughter. The King of Venice Beach is coming to Venice Beach live. The crowd's going to be excellent. We're giving stuff back to the homeless. We're giving money. We're going to hook them up where they can get food. We're going to make awareness of the plight of the homeless to show people how they can send money to them. I'm going to be cute. Yeah, people making all kind of flat stuff for me. It'll be funny. The new material is great. And if you want to be part of it, all you got to do is go to Indiegogo. And you go to Indiegogo and just put in Michael Kaya 3.0. You know what I was doing over the weekend? I just had the whole audience yell, Michael Kaya 3.0. I made them do it 3-4 times, sort of drumming into their head. So hopefully they'll go on and do it. I was looking for that commercial for it is...
Hey, I'm your boy Michael Kaya, world famous, world renowned, often talked about, alleged comedian, and the funniest man on the planet. Now, I know a lot of y'all know me as Showboat from House Party 3. Some of you know me as Gina's Boss. Some of you know me as Mr. Whitaker on Martin. But a lot of y'all remember me on Venice Beach, where from 1986 to 95, I told comedy every Saturday and Sunday from noon until 5 p.m., telling jokes and passing my hat. Well, guess what? I's going back to Venice Beach. Woo, woo, woo. Bring your mama, Pookie, run, run, all of them. I'm doing a one-hour special that's going to be on May 17th. Venice Beach, that's a Friday, but I don't have the money. This way you come in. Help me produce it. Go to Indiegogo. That's Indiegogo. Then put in Michael Collier, Collyar
3.0.
That's right. Indiegogo, Michael Collier 3.0. Or go to my very sexy webpage, therealmichaelcollier.com, and hit a button. It'll tell you all about Indiegogo and how you can help me produce one of the coldest classic comedy specials ever. That's all I got to say.
Nigga G'd up, sippin', sip, nigga dip, nigga set trip, nigga got a grip, nigga get a grip, nigga with the gangin', rollin' with the Alpine bangin'. Homie, what you got? A couple sacks to sell. Whippin' from weed to dope to max to sell.
Tommy, can you crip walk?
Oh, yeah.
You can?
Not as good as that little special.
I need you to teach me, man. I need to learn crip walk and moonwalk. Those two I have to learn. I got to put them on stage, man.
So, well, two things. One, I grew up thinking that they were supposed to be spelling crip while they was walking.
Oh, C-R-I-B.
Yeah.
Oh,
like,
I sort of get that in my
head. That's how I grew up, like, trying to learn how to do it. But then they started doing the thing where they moved their feet the same way. And I was like, I always grew up thinking that was blood walking. I don't know what they do now.
You're actually right, Tommy. The original way, like the original way, is to, you're supposed to spell it out. It's right. Crip walk. That's what it is.
I thought I heard that too.
Yeah.
For gang related?
Yeah.
For gangsters who don't.
That's
snitch,
the gang.
Don't
the gang bangers who make this.
And don't laugh, but they dance.
Yeah,
I'm confused. Okay, a
few more things, boss.
Yeah, go ahead.
You got tomorrow. Y'all watch Michael Collier 15 minutes with his wife.
Today is Wednesday?
No, I said tomorrow.
Oh, okay. All right.
Also, y'all got to make sure y'all get the book, Little Bobby White. And you should be able to get that book this weekend in Memphis, Tennessee at Chuckles. Michael Collier's going to be there live for 6 shows with myself.
Oh, you are on that show, aren't you?
Yes, I am. It's going to be a beautiful show. Chuckles last year, we tore that thing down.
You are a fantastic comedian when you actually show up. Now listen, hey, it's Michael Kaya on
your head
show.
This week.
Tommy did his thing, but we got to go. Katie showed up. We're so damn happy. Anyway, hey, it's the
Michael Kaya nappy.
If I had some hair, would be nappy. Bear's here. We all here. We had fun, dear. I hope it's clear. It's the Michael Kaya Morning Show. We had a little fun today, and now we got to go. We're doing our thing, y'all. Having lots of fun. See you later. It's Tuesday. We got to run. Hey, I'm going to hit that button right now. Continue to laugh. Ain't no need to frown. It's the Michael Kaya Morning Show.